Hi everybody, welcome back to Your Tips for You. Today I want to talk to you about detox diets. They're coming back into fad again. They've been around for a long time, but they seem to come in and out of favor. It kind of started recently with Beyonce going on a detox diet for a movie that she did, Dreamgirls, and she lost a lot of weight. And many of you have written to me wondering what my take is on that, because you know that I'm an advocate for diet and exercise. Well, more like healthy lifestyle and exercise. And you should be fine if you go on a detox diet for a short period of time if you're a healthy person. I personally don't recommend them. Most of them reduce your diet, restrict it so badly, and reduce it down to basically fluids and raw vegetables. One diet in particular, which is very popular, is called the Master Cleanse. You may have heard of it. It really involves drinking a lot of water with lemon juice in it and maple syrup and some cayenne pepper. Again, very depriving for your body. What happens when you do a diet like this is you're virtually shutting down your metabolism. Your body slows down to starvation mode immediately because you're depriving it of calories. And because of that, you can do more harm than good. When you slow down your metabolism, you're slowing your body's ability to digest foods and process foods. And that in turn can cause weight gain. So while you'll have a temporary weight loss from a diet like this, most of it is really due to water. You lose a lot of water and you lose muscle mass. And as soon as you start eating again, unfortunately, you put the weight right back on. Only this time, you have less muscle mass. So now you have your flab of fat and you have less muscle underneath. This diet is also quite difficult if you're a person who exercises. You really can't exert yourself and exercise and starve yourself like that. It's extremely unhealthy. This diet is especially unhealthy for teenagers and children and the elderly. Anybody who has any kind of a health condition shouldn't consider it. Pay attention to the climate. If you're in a very hot climate, I mean, your body needs calories. The best way for you to lose weight is not with a detox diet or a crash diet type thing, but to cut your calories, eating a healthy diet, exercising, reduce your portions. I have a great video up on portion control and maintaining a diet using portion control, eating healthy foods, complex carbohydrates, lean proteins, healthy fats, you know, dairies and fruit. And that's really the way to lose weight. You need to have calories every day. You need to burn calories. You need to keep your metabolism raised. You need to avoid things that will shut your metabolism down and slow it down. I wouldn't recommend this diet for anybody who's over 40. I think it's too strenuous for anybody who's past that age. I also think it's very bad for a teenager. And teenagers tend to be the ones who experiment with these things because they want to lose weight quickly. I think it can be very detrimental to your health. And also, a lot of these diets use laxatives as well, and sometimes enemas to speed up the detox process. I think this can be very damaging. I think it can really leave you prone to getting sick, feeling run down, migraine headaches. I mean, you may read some places where people feel better, they say their skin has cleared up, but you know, if you detox your diet by cutting out smoking and drinking alcohol and junk food and things like that, your skin will clear up, you will feel better. You don't need to restrict yourself from all of the good stuff. It's kind of like throwing the baby out with the bathwater. I mean, you're just shutting down to nothing. Yes, do cut out the junk food and the alcohol and the smoking, and you will feel better and your skin will look better. And also, these diets, they have you drink more water, and people don't drink enough water. And they also don't eat enough fruit, which is high in water content. All these are really good for your body. So there is a good thing about that, but it's just that that's not all you can eat. Now, our bodies already have a detoxification process. It goes through our liver and our kidneys, And anything that goes in, you know, is detoxified and it's reduced to something pure that the body can handle. The intestines do that as well. To say that, you know, you need to, you know, drink nothing but water and eat raw vegetables or whatever to do that, I just think it can be more harmful than good. So that's my take on it. I believe in something that's long-lasting and sustaining for weight loss or for just living your life so that you don't gain weight and that you can maintain a nice figure. That's a good way to live. And that would be, as I said, with a healthy diet, and yes, cutting out junk food and things like that. So if you read about these detoxification diets and you're tempted to try one, I say pass on it. I don't see the benefit. I see nothing but, you know, headaches, lethargy, inability to exercise, bad breath. You know, I don't see anything that good can come out of starving your body and slowing down your metabolism, which is the one thing that we really do try to raise so that we can burn calories faster and faster. And there's no substitute for a healthy lifestyle of exercise and a healthy diet to keep you feeling strong, healthy, fit, looking good, your hair looking good. You know, the first thing, when you deprive yourself of calories, the first thing that you'll see is your hair thin out. Your hair needs protein and it needs vitamins, and you'll see that it'll lose its shine, and, you know, crash diets are not the way to go. If you have excessive weight to lose, you know, seek out a Weight Watchers program or one of the programs that are designed to help you slowly lose weight, and it's a support system, it's a support group, and avoid the yo-yo crash dieting because it only leads to more unhappiness, frustration, crankiness, and lethargy. And eventually, most people get off of it and gain all the weight back. So it's not a good long-term solution. It's definitely not something that I recommend. Okay, so I hope you found this video helpful. Please subscribe because I have a lot more to come, something of interest to everyone. And thanks so much for viewing. I will see you soon. Bye now.